A very good morning to all of you students. As you remember, we were doing chapter number 5 accounting equation. We are going to begin on with that accounting equation, transactions only. As we were discussing the effects of each and every transaction and having positive and negative connotations, let us continue with that. Transaction, depreciation on asset. Now, for example, in a question you are given that you have to depreciate a machinery or depreciate a building at the rate rupees 10,000, or if it is mentioning at 10% and machinery's cost is given around 10 lakh, then 10 lakh amounts at the rate 10% is equal to rupees 1 lakh. Now you are going to depreciate that machinery by rupees 1 lakh. In the similar way, if it is given you have to depreciate building by rupees 15,000, you are going to charge that depreciation by rupees 15,000 on that building. Now, firstly, we have to see which two accounts are affected. The two accounts affected, one of them is being asset, that is building and machinery, whatsoever the case may be. Since depreciation is an expense, it is going to reduce your capital as well. If you remember, in the previous class also we discussed about any rent, salary, commission or any other kind of expenses reduces your capital. In the similar way, depreciation is also an expense and it will reduce your capital. Ultimately, depreciation will reduce the asset corresponding to whichever is given in the question as well as your capital. Students, now we will be discussing about few adjustment entries. If you remember, these cases were discussed in our accrual basis of accounting also. The very first comes here is prepaid expenses. Now, what is a prepaid expense? It is an expense which you have paid in advance. Since you have paid in advance, ultimately it will be going to reduce your cash. So the very first account affected is your cash. In the similar way, we are going to create one more account by the name of prepaid expenses. Now, this prepaid expenses is your asset. Thus, cash being reduced, your one asset being reduced, however, your other asset being increased, that is your prepaid expenses. Next comes is your outstanding expenses, that is expenses due but not paid. Now, these kind of expenses are your liabilities. You have to pay in future. That is why under your liabilities section, you are going to create an account by the name of outstanding expense. And since it is an expense which you have to pay, thus it will again reduce your capital by the corresponding amount. Because in accrual basis of accounting, we consider all expenses, whether we have paid or not, in this particular year. Thus, this outstanding expense also belongs to this year. We are going to reduce that corresponding expense from the capital. Now, in the similar way, we have accrued income. Now, what is an accrued income? It is that income which we have earned but not received. So, we have earned that income. It ultimately becomes an asset because in future, we are going to receive that cash. So, we are going to record accrued income as an asset under our asset section, as well as it is a profit which we are going to receive in future, kind of revenue you can say. That is why we are going to add that. Thus, any accrued income given in the question, or if you are given that any income earned but you have not received it, so you are going to record it as accrued income below your asset section and you are going to add by that corresponding amount, and under your capital column, you are going to add again with that corresponding amount. Now, next case comes is your income received in advance, that is your unearned income. Basically, you have received in advance, but you have not earned it. For example, any commission or any rent which you are receiving in advance. Since you are receiving the cash, thus cash is going to be increased. In the similar way, it is a liability. Reason being, you have just received it but you have not earned it for the time being. That is why it becomes your unearned income under your liabilities section, and again a liability is created. This means it is having a positive connotation. Alright students, proceeding to the next slide. Now, capital. Students, you will be encountered in this accounting equation with two terms, that is interest on capital as well as interest on drawings. Now, what are the effects of that? But before that, we should know that what is an interest on capital and what is an interest on drawing. Since when capital is increased, we always credit that capital. However, whenever drawings are made, it decreases your capital, thus drawings are debited. Alright? Now, any interest on capital, it is an expense for business. Reason being, if an owner has invested in your business, thus you are going to provide him with that kind of interest. Being, for example, if you have taken a loan, thus you are going to provide that interest to that person from whom you have taken the loan. In the similar way, capital is also a loan. You have taken from some person, that in that case you have to return that interest to that person. So for business, it is an expense, and any expense ultimately reduces your profit, that is your capital. In the similar way, that interest on capital is an income for the proprietor. That interest on capital is an income for the proprietor. Ultimately, it is added back to the capital. This means any interest on capital, at first, it is reducing your capital, and in the similar way, it is adding to your capital. As you can see in the above slide, it is mentioning interest on capital. Interest on capital is having two accounts affected, that is one capital and another one is also capital. That is capital only being increased and capital only being decreased. In the similar way, we have interest on drawings also. Now, interest on drawings is a profit for business. For example, if an owner has withdrawn from the business, now he is going to pay you interest on that. Now, it is a profit for the business, thus added to your profit, ultimately your capital. In the similar way, it is a loss as well as expense for the owner, that is owner's capital. Thus, it is again deducted from the capital. So, any interest on drawing, again, it is going to increase your capital by that corresponding amount and as well as decrease your corresponding amount by that corresponding amount. In a similar way, we can say interest on capital as well as interest on drawings have same kind of effects, that is increasing the capital and as well as decreasing the capital. Next, we move on to invested in shares. Students, for example, as a business, we are investing in some shares of some other companies. Now, since we are investing in shares, cash is being reduced. In the similar way, one asset is created, that is shares being invested. I'm not talking about if somebody has invested in your company's shares. I'm saying that if we are investing in some other company's shares, thus it is an asset, because on that shares we are going to get the profit in future. So that will ultimately be our income. That is why it is an asset for us. Thus shares being increased by that corresponding amount. Now we have one kind of transaction which says paid interest on loan as well as installment. Since we are paying cash, both on interest as well as installment, our cash is decreased by both amount, that is interest also as well as installment also. Now we are having a loan figure. That loan corresponding installment amount will be deducted from that loan amount, being your liability, as loan is recorded always under your liabilities section. And your interest, as we discussed, interest is always an expense. It is always going to reduce your capital, thus interest being deducted from your capital. Alright, moving on to the next. Next, we have purchased a building paid by raising a loan. This is a kind of capital expenditure which we have incurred by creating a liability. How? You have purchased an asset, that is your building, and you have created a liability, that is a loan. Thus, building recorded under your asset section and loan under your liabilities section added. Now, before discussing these kind of questions, as I told you in the previous accounting equation classes also, that under our dual aspect of accounting, that is double entry accounting system, minimum two accounts should be affected by any transaction. However, it could affect three or four as well. See over here, for example, if you are going to sell off goods which are costing at ₹15,000, however you are selling them at ₹18,000, but you are receiving only ₹5,000 in cash. Now how we are going to record this? We are going to sell goods at ₹15,000. Ultimately our stock, that goods represented as stock, gets reduced by ₹15,000. Next, students, from this 18,000, we are going to deduct 15,000 first, that is our 3,000 being the capital, as rather profit we can say, because we were supposed to sell them at 15,000, but we are selling it at 18,000. Thus that 3,000 is our profit, it will be added in the capital section. Now next comes is you are receiving only 5,000 as your cash. So your cash being increased by 5,000. Where your remaining amount goes, that your remaining amount will be recorded under your credit section. That is, you are going to receive in future, since you have sell off good and you are going to receive that in future from that person, or that person becomes your debtor. So out of that 18,000, you have only received 5,000. That 13,000 will be recorded under your debtors section. So stock, debtors, cash under your asset section, and capital in corresponding to your capital section, again balancing your accounting equation. Alright, moving on to next. For example, there are any goods which are destroyed by fire. If any loss which is due to fire, that is again your expense. Stock will be reduced by the similar amount and capital will also be reduced by the similar amount. Now, as we discussed transaction number 25, we even have transaction number 27. Now, what are the basis of this transaction? For example, you have sold goods for cash costing ₹10,000 and on credit ₹15,000. Basically, you are selling here two kinds of goods. One is on cash and one is on credit. But both at a profit of rupees, both at a profit of 20%. So firstly, we are going to reduce our cash by the corresponding amount. Sorry, stock. Stock says 10,000 plus 15,000, that is 25,000 to be reduced by stock. Next comes is your cash. How much cash we are receiving? Students, we are selling the goods at a profit of 20%. In the previous 25th transaction, you were already given with the amount. However, here you have to calculate that amount. On 10,000 at 20%, you get ₹2,000 as your profit. So for cash, you are receiving 10,000 plus 2,000, that is your 12,000 being total cash you are receiving. In the similar way, debtors, that is when you are selling the goods on credit, that is ₹15,000. 15,000 at the rate 20% gives you around 3,000 as a figure. Now this 15,000 plus 3,000, that is 18,000, will be recorded under your debtor section, that is you will be receiving in future. What happens? This 2,000 sold goods on cash at the rate 20%, sold goods on debtors, sold goods on credit at the rate ₹20%, 3,000. This 2,000 plus 3,000 is total profit, which is 5,000, which will be added in your capital section. I hope this transaction is clear to you. Moving on to next. Students, this is the last slide which we are going to see regarding these transactions effect. After this, all the transactions regarding your whatever has been given in your books or which you ever will be coming across in the upcoming examinations, every transaction has been discussed over here. Goods sold on credit and received bills receivable for the same. For example, you are selling the goods on credit and you are not receiving any cash. However, you are receiving the bills receivable for that. Goods, this means stock is going to be reduced and one asset, that is bills receivable, being created, that is in positive connotation. Next comes is your, if you are selling the goods on credit, only this transaction is given. For example, second transaction says goods sold on credit. So you are going to record stock as negative and debtors as positive. You are going to open one more account, that is by debtors account. However, later, let's say fifth or sixth transaction mentions you are, that you are receiving bills receivable for the goods which were sold on credit. So now debtors are supposed to be reduced by that amount, and one another account will be created on your asset section, that is bills receivable. Ultimately, your debtors will become zero after that, and your bills receivable and account will be created under your asset section. Similarly, we have goods purchased on credit and accepted one bills payable. Again, we are purchasing the goods. This means stock is being increased and one liability is also being increased. That is your bills payable. You have to pay in future. That is supposed to be added under your liabilities section. In the similar way, we can have, if you have purchased goods on credit, but we are accepting or we are granting that bills payable at a later date. So initially, for the transaction number 3 or 4, whichever is mentioning goods purchased on credit, we are going to record it as stock being increased, creditors as an account being increased. However, if transaction 7 says accepted bills payable, at that point of time, you are going to reduce your creditors by the corresponding amount, as well as you are going to open one more account, which is by the name of bills payable. All right. Now we are going to discuss few accounting equation practical questions. As you can see, the question says, commenced business with cash rupees 50,000. Purchased goods for cash rupees 20,000 and on credit 30,000. Sold goods for cash 40,000, which are costing rupees 30,000. See over here, your goods are sold for cash, that is 40,000. The cost of the goods was 30,000. Here you can estimate rupees 10,000 is your profit. Rent paid 500 being an expense. Salary paid 5,000 being an expense. Now this is an outstanding rent, rupees 100. Outstanding rent is an outstanding expense. Outstanding salary is an outstanding expense, which we are going to discuss in this particular question. Bought furniture for rupees 5,000 on credit, thus creditors being created. Bought refrigerator for personal use. Purchased computer for cash, cash withdrawn for personal use, interest on drawings charged and interest on capital. You have to show the effect of the above transactions using your accounting equation. See, the very first transaction was when you commenced business with cash rupees 50,000. As you can see over here, when your cash is being created, you are going to record cash and below that rupees 50,000. In the similar way, capital rupees 50,000. I hope you all are clear with the format of accounting equation, which says the first column should be for serial number, second column for transactions. However, the third column goes in a wide length of your page, where you are going to record your assets as well as liabilities plus capital. For each and every transaction, you are going to open one by one each and every account. All right, students. Now, second says purchased goods for cash rupees 20,000 and on credit rupees 30,000. Ultimately, your total goods 20,000 plus 30,000 being 50,000. So you are purchasing it, the stock is being added by rupees 50,000. As you can see, since in the second transaction your stock is being created, however, there was no stock in the first transaction, thus you have put zero in corresponding row to that first transaction, however added in the second transaction. First and second transaction will give you new equation. Now your cash being 20,000 being reduced from 50,000, which will give you 30,000 as your cash, stock being 50,000, and when you'll move back to liability section, since you're purchasing the goods on credit, one more account being added over here, creditors, you are going to record liabilities, and under that creditors by the corresponding amount, 30,000. And students, as you can see over here as well, in the first transaction, no creditor was created. Thus, you are going to put zero over that corresponding row. In this transaction, till transaction number two, no furniture, no computer, no expenses outstanding has been created yet. You are going to create it as you are going to proceed with the another transactions. Transaction number three says sold goods for cash, rupees 40,000, which are costing rupees 30,000. Now, you are receiving the cash 40,000. Record that 40,000 under your cash. Goods are being sold for 30,000. Stock is being reduced by 30,000. As we discussed, the remaining amount becomes your profit. Then 10,000 is added below your capital section, as well as all other figures, that is your furniture. I'm so sorry, only creditors. Since only creditors have been created till date, thus your creditors, you will be putting zero over there. That's it. Moving on to the next. It says rent paid, salaries paid. As we are very much aware, these both are your expenses. You are going to reduce rent and salaries paid amount from the cash as well as from your capital. Again, your new equation is to be created. That is 64,500 plus 20,000 till here is equal to 30,000. That is, creditors has been created, plus 53,400. No other account has been created yet. Now, we are purchasing the furniture for rupees 5,000 on credit. Here we are going to record furniture. How? You are going to put furniture plus furniture below your asset section. And since you are purchasing it on credit, we have already created the creditors account. We are going to record this 5,000 below your creditors section. Thus, no cash, cash being zero, no stock, stock being zero, furniture created plus 5,000 is equal to 5,000 below your creditors plus capital being zero because no capital has been created. Again, giving you the equation, new equation, as 64,500 plus 20,000 plus 5,000 is equal to 35,000 plus 53,400 till yet. Now it says you are buying the furniture for personal use, rupees 5,000. Students, word mentioned is personal use. Whenever the word personal use is mentioned, it is your drawings. You are not considering it as your asset. So no refrigerator is being created. You are going to reduce your drawings from the cash as well as your capital. Thus, cash being reduced by 5,000 and capital being reduced by 5,000. Next comes is your purchased computer for cash. Since it is an asset, because it is not mentioning that any personal use, this means it is being presumed that this computer has been purchased specifically for the office use only. So now below your asset section, you are going to record this computer, and corresponding to that, you are going to record 20,000, and cash is being reduced, thus reducing your cash. Now, since you all know computer being an asset is also created, and we are only going to record this 20,000 corresponding to that eighth number row, thus from below, sorry, above that, all the transactions you have to put 00000. That till 8th number of transaction, there was nothing related to computers. Next comes is your cash withdrawn for personal use. Again, it being a drawing, cash is also reduced and your capital is also reduced. The very next transaction comes interest on drawings and interest on capital. Now, interest on drawings, as we discussed, it is going to affect capital, and it is going to increase our capital also, and it is going to reduce our capital also. Thus, plus 500, minus 500. In the similar way, interest on capital, minus 1,000, plus 1,000. Ultimately, both interest on drawings and as well as capital is giving your capital as the two accounts being affected. As you can see over here, all the accounting transactions have been recorded and your accounting equation being created. Now you have to see that accounting equation, that is new equation, that is the last final equation, is equal or not. 29,500 plus 20,000 plus 5,000 plus 20,000 should always be equal to 35,000 plus 1100 plus 38,400. All right, students, proceeding to the next accounting equation exam. But before that, let us consider one balance sheet. Students, you will be asked to prepare one balance sheet. Now, what is that and how it is supposed to be maintained? As we already know, liabilities and assets. Liabilities are supposed to be recorded in your left side in your balance sheet, and assets are supposed to be recorded in your right side. So, as you can see over here, from cash, if you can see cash, the in new equation, your total cash amounts to rupees 29,500 in the final equation, in the last column you can see. Thus, you are going to put assets and cash in hand as rupees 29,500. In the similar way, we have stock as 20,000. Stock 20,000. Furniture 5,000. Computer 20,000. In the similar way, we have liabilities also. Now, liabilities, creditors being 35,000. It includes creditor for furniture also, as it was being mentioned in the question. Expenses outstanding 1100. Capital 38,400. Basically, what we are doing over here is, through that accounting equation, we are going to prepare a kind of summary. That is your financial statement. Now, balance sheet is a financial statement representing the summary at the end. That were all the transactions which you have encountered over a period of year. Now, you are going to summarize them and show at the end ultimately what cash you are having in hand, what stock you are having in hand, what is the amount of furniture you are having, what is the amount of computer you are having, who are your creditors and by what amount your creditors are there, how many expenses are outstanding, and what is the corresponding amount of your capital. Thus, we are going to record it in our balance sheet. Moving on to the next question. The next question says, Manu started business with cash. He opened a bank account and transferred rupees 4 lakh from his savings account. Now, he is opening a bank account and he is transferring rupees 4 lakh from his savings account. That is, he is going to start his business. It is this business investment. Let us consider this. Started business with cash and opened bank account with rupees 4 lakh. Cash being created, rupees 1 lakh. Bank being created, rupees 4 lakh. Now, since he is investing rupees 4 lakh, during the commencement of the business, this means this 4 lakh plus 1 lakh is equal to 5,000, which will be your capital for the time being. Next. Purchased a building from Sohan for rupees 12 lakh. Paid by taking a loan from SBI. Now, students, this question says you have purchased a building from Sohan, which is amounting to rupees 12 lakh, but you have taken a loan for around 10 lakh. So, basically, what we are going to do over here is loan from SBI you are going to record under your liabilities section. So, we are going to create a liability, that is, we have taken a loan from SBI, but we have taken a loan for around rupees 10 lakh only. However, your building cost is for around 12 lakh. So, we are taking or presuming it over here as the remaining amount, that is rupees 2 lakh, that you have paid from the bank only, thus reducing your 2 lakh from the bank amount. Next comes is your paid interest on loan and installment of rupees 1 lakh. Now, students, installment as well as your interest on loan has been paid. as we discussed, this accounting transaction. Since you are paying the interest on loan as well as installment also, so over here, since everything is associated with the bank and your in-hand cash is just rupees 1 lakh, so over here you are going to reduce this 1,20,000 both from your banks. And since you are paying rupees 1 lakh only as an installment, so whole loan from SBI was rupees 10 lakh. One installment being paid, that is rupees 1 lakh, ultimately will give you rupees 9 lakh as the remaining loan amount left. And as we know, interest being an expense, we are going to reduce it from the capital, that is rupees 20,000. Next, we are going for the another transaction. The another transaction says, purchased goods from Rohan on credit. You are purchasing the goods from Rohan on credit. That is rupees 1 lakh. Now, very easy. Purchased goods. One new account is created. That is your stock by amount rupees 1 lakh. In the similar way, creditors rupees 1 lakh being created. As you can see in the corresponding question. Besides your loan from SBI, one another account is created. That is your creditors under your liabilities section. And by the rupees 1 lakh. Next is your goods returned to Rohan costing rupees 20,000. Students, as you can see over here, the goods which you have purchased, you are going to return to Rohan, which are costing rupees 20,000. Now, see. Transaction number 5, goods returned to Rohan costing rupees 20,000. The accounts to be affected, since you have purchased those goods, ultimately you are going to reduce your stock by 20,000. In the similar way, since you have not paid any cash for it, creditors was created, thus we are going to reduce our creditors also by the corresponding amount. Thus, goods returned to Rohan affects two accounts by the name stock and by the name your creditors. Next comes is your sold goods costing rupees 40,000 for rupees 50,000 on credit to Ram. Here it is being sold on, or it is being sold on credit. Now see, transaction number 6, sold goods rupees worth rupees 50,000, you are not receiving any cash for it. However, the goods cost was around for 40,000. So record 40,000 below your stock section. And since you are selling those goods on credit, this means you will be receiving that amount in future. Thus, one account by the name of debtors is being created and you will be receiving 50,000 in future. Thus, 50,000 is being created over here. And as we all know, that goods were for only 40,000. This means rupees 10,000, that is the remaining balance being your profit, will added in your capital section. Next, took goods from business for personal use. Again, being a drawing, your personal use drawings are going to affect your capital. And here you are taking the stock, not the cash. You are taking the goods. So you are going to reduce that corresponding amount from your stock. So any transaction, you have to see what it is saying. If it is mentioning cash, you have to reduce the cash. If it is saying stock, if it is saying goods, you have to reduce from the corresponding stock. All right, students. Next comes is your accrued interest. Accrued interest, rupees 5,000. That is your income which you have earned but you have not received. How we are going to record this accrued interest? As we discussed, accrued interest, for that we are going to create one separate asset under our asset section, that is by the name of accrued interest, and similar corresponding amount will be added in our capital. Alright, students. Next is your commission received in advance. You have received in advance, that is cash being received in advance, you are going to record in your cash section. And in the similar way, since it is a liability, because you will be receiving the benefit for that, or you will be rather, it is a kind of liability for you. So you will be recording this commission received in advance under your liability section by the name 20,000. All right, students, because you are going to provide for that benefit in future. Next is cash received from Ram. Since Ram is a debtor, thus you are going to reduce your cash balance as well as you're going to reduce your debtor's balance as well as you're going to increase by that corresponding amount below your cash section. So ultimately it will give your final equation by ₹1,30,000 plus 80,000 plus 12 lakh plus 30,000 plus 40,000 plus 5,000, which should be equal to your 9 lakh plus 80,000 plus 20,000 plus 4,85,000. All right, students, till here your accounting equation 80% chapter has been completed. Tomorrow I'm going to show you how you are going to present your accounting equation in your examination. Till then, have a good day. Stay safe, stay home.